What's going on, everybody? This is Paul, aka Powerhouse 21. Today we're actually going to try to get the internet in all the corners of the house, including outside on the patio and even in the garage, but we're not going to use any Wi-Fi. Today we're going to be testing the Comtrend PG-9182PT and the 9182S4 Powerline to Ethernet adapters. Comtrend was gracious enough to send these over to me to test, so let's go ahead and find out what type of applications these could be used for. Now I have to be honest, I have used Powerline adapters in the past. You know, it was 6 or 7 years ago, and it was definitely not through Comtrend, it was through other companies, but I just had nothing but issues, dropped and horribly slow connections, just made them practically unusable. But that was quite a few years ago, so I may have to amend my statements about Powerline adapters, but all of that can wait to the end. We still need to see where we can put these things. We are going to be using two different types of Comtrend units. One is a Powerline adapter with a power outlet pass-through, so you don't lose an outlet just because you need to expand the internet to that room. And the other one is a Powerline adapter with a built-in 4-port gigabit switch. Comtrend also makes two other Powerline units in this series. One has a built-in AC Wi-Fi access point to extend the range of your network and create a Wi-Fi hotspot, and the other actually has two ports with PoE to expand the functionality of IP cameras, PoE-powered Wi-Fi access points, and VoIP home and office phones. The nice thing is, you can mix and match these, and you can have up to 16 of them in your house. Each of these units can actually be used to transmit or receive internet data. It just depends on which one you actually hook up the hardline internet connection into versus the one that you want to expand it to. If you're worried about running out of ports, either with the 4-port gigabit switch version or the power pass-through with the single, you can always add a 5-port gigabit switch or something like that to expand your possibilities. According to the Quick Start Guide, the easiest and fastest way to pair these devices is to use the pass-through unit against the wall and actually plug the second one directly into the first. In our case, it would be the power pass-through going against the wall, and it would be the 4-port gigabit switch unit going into it. Once all of the blinking lights have stopped blinking and either gone solid or out, you press the sync buttons on the side for 2 seconds each on each unit, and once that is connected, it creates a secure network between the two devices. Now that they're paired, we can go ahead and unplug them both from the wall, and we can take them to wherever we need to in the house. While using these, there are actually indicator lights built into them to take the guesswork out of a particular plug and tell you what type of connection it is. Green means you have a 40 or more megabit per second connection between the two, yellow is a connection between 5 and 40, and red is a connection of less than 5 megabits per second. There's also a way to log into these as well to adjust settings and update the firmware. All of that information is in the user's manual and is way more advanced than I need to know, but many of you may have fun messing around with them and trying to unlock some hidden potential. I'm honestly not sure if there are limitations to where I can and can't put these other than outside my electrical network, of course. But let me go ahead and test these out. Let me see what type of places that I can find around the house to put them, and I will be right back. Okay, I have to say, I am highly impressed with the performance of these things. The whole process really was plug and play. I didn't have to repair the two devices every time I unplugged both or one or anything like that, so moving them around the house for testing was a lot faster than I had anticipated. I did see the inevitable trend of the transfer speed slowing down the more distance there was between them, and that's to be expected, but I'm more impressed that I was able to keep a consistent connection without any drops or major slowdowns in every scenario. I do consider there to be a very usable speed in every location I tested. The units do auto-connect every time you plug them in. It takes about 30 seconds to a minute for it to initialize, but so far I find that's par for the course when dealing with a piece of network equipment. The tests had two components. One was a copy of a gigabyte file transferred to and from the storage server. And using Windows Task Manager, I looked for the highest reported speed achieved. And yes, I know Windows Task Manager probably isn't the most precise for a test like this, but for a simple and easy solution to check the interface speed, it'll do exactly what we're needing it to do. The second part of the test was a program called LAN speed test. And instead of doing the similar 1 gigabyte file transfer, which it could do for us, I actually had it do a read-write transfer in more of a real-world scenario. I set the software to have 30 packets of information transferred. They were randomly created during the test and ranged from 20 kilobytes to 50 megabytes. To me, this created a more realistic situation because many people, including myself, could end up using a device like this to transfer photos to cloud services, files for work over a VPN, and basically any situation that would be sending or receiving varied size of files where the connection speed won't be getting up to the maximum because of those file sizes. This program works by writing data to a network drive and then reading it back, so it all depends on your drive speeds and current network, but I feel it's more realistic with what I and probably many others out there do on a daily basis. To rule out any shenanigans between the devices, I started with plugging them into themselves into the same wall outlet. I know these wouldn't be used this way, but figuring out what speeds they could get while piled on top of each other was the first step. These, of course, were the fastest speeds achieved, reaching 370 megabits per second on the 1 gig file transfer, and in the 30 randomized size packet test, there was an average of 174 megabits per second read and 75 megabit average speeds for writing. Moving on to the other tests, they included, again, both plugged into each other, but this time on a surge protector. We have a test where they are hooked up in the same room on different wall sockets. Same room, but the transmitter unit is on a surge protector and the other is on a different wall outlet. We have an office to studio situation, office to kitchen, office to front room of the house, the office to the basement wall outlet, but going through a 50-foot 14-gauge extension cord, which did cause major slowdowns, but still a solid connection. We also have office to the garage wall outlet, office to the patio, and finally, family room to the patio. As I said before, you can see how the speeds decrease over the increased distance, but none of these failed to connect, and no test failed to transfer data. And as I've said many, many times over the course of making these types of videos, you don't need a 500 megabit connection to watch Netflix on a smart TV or play a game online. Some people's internet connections aren't even that fast. And although your household may actually have a fast connection because of the amount of people that are constantly using the internet, it may not be something that you need for day to day. Normal working from home or browsing the internet or streaming Netflix or Hulu or something like that won't even max out a 300 megabit connection even at the worst of times. And if you have a job that does, you may not be looking at Powerline adapters anyway. Averaging 100, 75, or even 50 megabit will still give you a great working, browsing, or watching content experience. Unless you're transferring large data files or something like the GCA 6000 or 7000 coax to Ethernet adapters, check out those videos right here, would actually be better for you. But if you're not doing things like that, we can put internet pretty much anywhere with these. Comtrend.com has tons of networking solutions for the home and office, from coax to Ethernet or Powerline adapters to PoE switches, injectors, and extenders. Check out Comtrend.com for your next networking purchase. So thank you so much for watching, and thank you to Comtrend again for supplying these wonderful devices for me to test and review and making this video possible. Coming up on the channel, there's a new vacuum tube video that you don't want to miss, so get those headphones ready. And I have an accessory for tube amp owners that you will want to see. If you like this type of content and like this video, go ahead and give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down, that's okay. But if you did like it, give me a thumbs up, think about subscribing, and hit the little bell because there are more videos coming out. Thank you so much for watching. Have a wonderful day.